Welcome to part 5 of my rigging tutorial. We're in the middle of initializing the mesh to fit into the skeleton. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is work on some of these joints. So for instance, this elbow joint here. I'm going to select these. I'm assigning this to the lower arm, but I also want to assign it to the upper arm. Now, in order to do this, you're going to have to choose 2 links. And you can even choose 3 links or 4 links. You'll notice that it turned dark red. That's because it's now assigned to 2 different links. Whenever you see it dark red, that is what it means. If it's bright red, it means it's not assigned, it's only got 1 link. Now, I'm going to lock those assignments. And you can't weight the vertices and do the next step unless you lock them. Now I'm going to go to type in weights. You'll notice here that the vertices that I have selected and locked have 1 weight to the upper arm and 1 to the forearm. I can change that. Let's say that I want it to be mostly on the forearm when it moves, with maybe half as much on the upper arm. So in that case, I can press 0.5. And from now on, when I move that upper arm, this will move a little bit. But if I move the lower arm, it will move a lot more. And you can just kind of experiment with this, and I'll get into that in the next tutorial. For now, it's important to select everything on a joint and make sure that it's assigned to 2 different bones. If I was to take that wrist and assign it only to the hand bone, the skin here would just stretch horribly when you move the hand. So you want it to have some influence on this bone as well, because that way it will bend a little bit more naturally when you move it. It's also possible to save and load different physiques. It generally doesn't work very well because you're always changing your mesh. Or maybe not always, but I mean, meshes look different. But it helps to save a physique sometimes. So you go up to the top of your physique modifier, and you see here you get the icons for saving and loading. So I can save it, or I can go ahead and load another goblin physique that I made. This generally doesn't work unless you have a skeleton with the same number of hands and legs and fingers and toes. So now that I've done that, you can see everything is locked, everything is assigned. And this is from a physique I made earlier. But you can see that everything that's bright red is assigned to just 1 link. So these shoulder horns are going to be assigned just to the clavicle. That means that when I move the arm, it's not going to pull in weird ways. Everything that's dark red is assigned to more than 1 thing. These horns on the legs, if I was to not assign them to both the upper and lower leg, it would just look extremely strange, like it's kind of frozen in place when he bends his knees. I'll give an example of that right now. So I'm going to click up to the top of physique mode, head over to the animation panel. I'm going to select the root, so I'm not selecting the mesh anymore. I'm now in the skeleton. And I'm going to click off figure mode. You always want to exit figure mode when you start animating. That's very important. So here I am. I've got the root node selected. I'm out of figure mode. And I'm going to go ahead and load a biped file. I'm going to load Goblin Walk. There we go. And you will see that I can go ahead and hide some of the bone objects and the helpers. And if I press play, which is the question mark, the reason his hands are like that is because he's usually carrying weapons. But you can see that the mesh moves the way I want it to, more or less. It does look a little bit strange, but that's only because it's a low poly mesh. I never bothered to make it extremely high end and high poly because you never see him up this close. But for a far away look, it works as well as I want it to.